First, let's examine the concept of face validity. An outcome measure must capture what it claims to measure for the study to appropriately label the intervention's effect on an outcome of interest. The WWC says that an outcome measure has face validity when it has a clear definition and captures what it claims to measure. When assessing face validity, the WWC requires alignment between the description of the measure and the content of the measure, such as the questions on a test. For example, if the measure is called the Math Achievement Test, does it measure students' math knowledge and skills? If an outcome measure does not have face validity, then differences in outcomes between the groups do not provide information about what it claims to measure. Any finding based on that outcome measure will receive the Does Not Meet WWC Group Design Standards rating. Outcome measures must also have a high degree of reliability to meet WWC requirements. The reliability of a measure captures whether it would yield consistent scores from different administrations. A highly reliable measure indicates that the observed scores have low measurement error. For example, a reliable measure will return similar results if a study gives the same assessment to the same group of students repeatedly. For example, imagine that these target images represent the outcome measure of interest. The center of the target represents the concepts that the outcome measure claims to measure. An outcome measure with reliability produces measurements that hit the target consistently in the same general area. Two of these images represent an outcome measure with reliability. The first target represents a measure that is not reliable because the results are scattered across the whole target. The results in the second target are clustered in a single area, so this measure is reliable. The results do not need to hit the center of the target to be considered reliable. The third target represents a measure that has both face validity and reliability because the results are clustered at the center of the target. How does the WWC assess reliability? There are three ways for an outcome measure to meet the reliability standard. The first way to demonstrate reliability is to offer evidence that the individual items or questions in an outcome measure provide consistent information about a respondent's knowledge, skills, attitudes, or behaviors. This is called internal consistency. For an outcome measure to have high internal consistency, the items in the measure must focus narrowly on a set of key concepts. For example, a measure that includes items that assess both reading and math skills is unlikely to have a high internal consistency because some students will score high on the math items but low on the reading items. The WWC requires an internal consistency statistic of 0.5 or higher. An example of an internal consistency statistic is Cronbach's alpha. The second way is to demonstrate sufficient test-retest reliability. Test-retest reliability measures to what extent the same individuals get similar scores in repeated assessments. The WWC requires a test-retest reliability statistic of 0.4 or higher. The third way to demonstrate that an outcome measure has reliability is by showing that different raters scored the same individuals similarly, a measure called inter-rater reliability. The WWC requires that inter-rater reliability, often measured as the percent agreement between the raters or using a measure called kappa, is 0.5 or higher. If the authors do not demonstrate that the outcome measure is reliable, then any analysis using that outcome measure will receive the Does Not Meet WWC Group Design Standards rating. The review protocol will document any reliability requirements that are different from or additions to the standards we just discussed. The review protocol defines the scope and parameters for the review. The protocol also specifies any topic-specific applications of the design standards. Some review protocols set higher reliability requirements for certain outcome measures common to reviews in that topic area, such as for outcome measures that are especially subjective for raters to assess. For example, the Teaching Elementary School Students to Be Effective Writers Practice Guide, focuses on a holistic writing score, which usually relies on a rubric. The guide's review protocol, the Elementary School Writing Practice Guide review protocol, requires the measure to demonstrate inter-rater reliability of 0.80 or higher. A reliability statistic is sometimes not available for an outcome measure. In some cases, even though the study doesn't present a reliability statistic, the measure can meet the reliability requirement. The WWC automatically considers behavior outcomes measured using administrative data reliable because these outcomes are straightforward to measure. Examples include graduation from high school, school enrollment, and grade retention. Other outcomes are so straightforward to measure that a content expert or lead methodologist for a review team can determine that a single rater could score them with low error. For example, coders can very accurately score measures of how many words a child spelled correctly in a passage, or whether or not a child counted to 10 correctly. More generally, some review protocols may describe how to assess other outcome measures that are unlikely to have reliability information.